Okay, everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is another topic video, and today's topic video, we will be talking about my thoughts and opinions on the Q&A YouTube video that Joe Johnston is. If you don't know who Joe Johnston is, he is the director for the upcoming new Narnia film, The Sliver Chair. And he, if you don't know who he is, he is also a visual effects designer. He's worked on many different movies, such as Star Wars and Star Wars Empire Strikes Back. And he was an author of a couple of Star Wars books. And so that's awesome. As a huge Star Wars fan, I think that's awesome. And the fact that he has worked with George Lucas and worked with Star Wars, it makes me have a lot of faith in him. I did a video about a couple weeks ago, maybe a month ago now, of my thoughts about him directing Sliver Chair when it was announced, and I didn't mention that because I didn't know it. I didn't know it because I really didn't know who he was, and so I definitely wanted to mention that in this video. He's also worked on Indiana Jones, Jumanji, and other things, so he's known, and he's been out there and worked on pretty big movies, so... As you guys know, if you've been following my channel from the start, you guys know I'm a diehard Star Wars fan. That's like one of my main passions and things I do on this channel, even though I haven't done a whole lot of Star Wars videos lately just because I haven't got a lot of merchandise and stuff like that. When The Last Jedi stuff starts coming out, like more Rey figures, more Leia figures, a Snoke figure possibly, I'll definitely start doing more Star Wars video and other things here and there. I'm just packing up my house because I'm planning to move. I'm trying to move, so most of the stuff is going in boxes. Anyways, off topic. I'm a huge Star Wars fan, I'm a huge Narnia fan too. And when I mean Narnia, and everyone has their preferences, and everyone prefers one thing to another, like, some people with Star Wars prefer just the OT, some people might prefer just the prequel trilogy, some people might prefer the saga as a whole, which don't get me wrong, I prefer the prequel, that's my favorite part of the story, but I love the saga as a whole because it's one big story. Like a lot of movie sagas and trilogy, Narnia for instance. And when I say I am a huge Narnia fan, I read the first book a long, long time ago when I was younger. And I love all of Narnia, but when I say that, I mean the movies, three movies. The first movie, Lion, Witch and the Wardrobe, the second movie, Prince of Caspian, and the third movie, The Voyage of the Dawn Treader. So last year, about September, October maybe, I saw the first movie in theaters in 2005. This is when Disney and Walden Media were running it, and I loved it. I thought it was really cool. I was really interested in the character of the White Witch. Still am. She's actually my favorite Narnia character, and that's the only Narnia movie I saw. So I decided, to go back and watch the other two. When I was a kid, knowing that the White Witch wasn't in the other two didn't really interest me, but she actually is. She's not a big part in it, but she makes cameos in both of the other films. And so I went back and I watched Prince Caspian, and I love all of these movies, and I liked Prince Caspian a lot, but I felt it dragged on. To me, there were parts where towards the end, like, you think, oh, this is gonna be the ending, or oh, that's gonna be the ending, and then the movie just keeps going on. There's a lot of parts that they could have stopped at, but I still like it. It's also by Disney, and the director of both the first movie the second movie is Andrew Adamson. He did both the Lion, Witch and the Wardrobe and the Prince Caspian, and I liked it. One of the characters, so when I get into something, as you guys probably know if you've been with my channel, usually when I get into something, I post on YouTube, post on Facebook what I'm into, but I really get into stuff. Depends what it is. If I start to like something, I really, really get into it. And some people call it obsessed, but that's just the way I've always been. And so I've got really into it, and I can feel when a certain character is going to be my favorite or my like character. I just can feel. So one character I really liked was the character of Edmund. In 2005, if you asked me who my favorite of the children was, I probably would have said Susan. But she would be my second favorite actually now. I just really love the character of Edmund. He starts out as a jerk, mean to everyone, stubborn, attitude-y, and he makes friends with the White Witch. I'm not gonna go into the whole plot, and makes a mistake. But then soon after he realizes his mistake, and then once he gets back with his sisters and joins Eisen, he makes up for his mistake. And I thought that was really brave of him, really mature of him, really heroic of him, and I really, that's what made me fall in love with the character. And in the other movies, I really thought he was the hero, kind of the other two movies. He really was a true hero. He fought, he wasn't perfect. He, dealt with his insecurities and stuff, but I really love that. I love the actor, Skandar Keynes, who plays him. He's an amazing actor. Fortunately, Skandar gave up acting after the last movie and just wasn't into it, and which is fine. I respect whatever, as much as I would love to see him in movies again, whatever he wants to do with his life is obviously up to him. And he's just very special to me, as all my favorite actors are. So I did like the Voyage of the Dawn Trader a little bit more. I know a lot of people didn't like it because it didn't stay true to the book a whole lot, but my thing is, yes, it's good. It's when some movies stay true to the books, but also it's okay. I think it's okay if you change it up a little bit and kind of add your view of it. Things. And I think that's what the director was doing with Dawn Trader, and the director of that was Michael Apted. Andrew Adamson was not the director of Dawn Trader, and Disney had nothing to do with Dawn Trader. This was Fox after Prince Caspian, Disney dropped it. But the first two movies are still Disney, obviously. And, and look, there is the White Witch right there. I'm not gonna spoil it, but there she is right there. So she does make cameos. I think the White Witch is the best villain of the movies, of the story in general, and I think Tilda Swinton was the perfect choice for the White Witch. I think all the children in the movies were cast perfectly. I couldn't imagine them any other way. And this is just my opinion. You guys might feel differently, which is totally 100% alright. So I know a lot of people weren't big fans of this. I liked it, and one of the main reasons I did like it is because Edmund was there, and I got, he got a lot of screen time. So, I don't think if, Edmund was there, I wouldn't have liked it as much. Again, I think if someone's directing a movie and it's based off a book, or it's even a remake to a movie, try to stick to the book a little bit, but also put your own point of view on it, put your own spin on it, and I think that's what the director was trying to do with this. It wasn't 100% like the book, it was just their own point of view. So anyways, I also did, when I was a kid, watch the BBC versions, which I also do have. I got the movies and the BBC versions on eBay, on a set. It was used for $25, so I couldn't pass that up. I only saw the first one, though, and I liked it when I was a kid, but I went back and watched a couple scenes here and there, and it is outdated. You can tell the props are obviously fake, and it doesn't hold a lot against the movie, Oops, is this open? Okay, good. For the time, these came out in, 2000, in the 80s, so You can't expect much. But there is the first one, The Lion, Witch, and the Wardrobe. And honestly, when I was watching scenes of this, it was hard to get, you know, like, this is the White Witch in the movie. It was, like, hard to get Tilda Swinton out of my head. There is, I forget which one's Edmund, but, you know, it was hard to get Skandar Keynes out of my head and the other actors, you know, so it was a little hard for me because, in my opinion, they are the definition of those characters. So I only saw this one, and I just got the set because it was a good deal, and I wanted to own. So this one is both Prince Caspian and Don Treader in one. There's two. These are just little, this is a series. And then Silver Chair. And I've been thinking about watching this just to kind of get more of an idea of what the story is about. Obviously, there wouldn't be the movies or BBC without the book. I read the first book a long, long time ago. Chapter books have a hard time keeping my attention, so if there's a movie based off a book, I just go to the movie. But here's the book and Silver Chair. You know, the last movie was Don Treader, and the last movie came out in 2010. And there hasn't been a Narnia movie ever since. As I said, I did a video about when Joe Johnston was announced to direct this Narnia movie. And we didn't know much, it was just announced. And he made a YouTube video, which I love it when celebrities, actors make YouTube videos on YouTube. I think that's really clever. I think that gives us a chance to get to know them more instead of them being on like a talk show and where they're scripted and have to say things. Obviously Joe couldn't say a whole lot because, you know, he's working on the movie, but pretty much it's a totally new trilogy. I'm really hoping it is a sequel to obviously the Don Treader, and it's new, and I'm kind of wondering if he's gonna do what are the other ones? The Horse and His Boy, Magician's Nephew, and The Last Battle. I wonder if he's gonna take on those movies too. And the Narnia movies, especially the first one, this was like a Lord of the Rings movie. I watched it with a friend a couple weeks ago, and because I love it and I wanted her to see it. And it's like Lord of the Rings, but not as a big scale as Lord of the Rings was. And I love both stories. I love both trilogies. And Joe Johnston pretty much said it's going to be his own take on what the Silver Chair is, based on the book. Without C.S. Lewis, obviously there wouldn't be the movie, the BBC. So I'm thankful for C.S. Lewis for writing these books, because I probably wouldn't be an Narnia fan right now. Same with Star Wars, even though A New Hope is like my least favorite Star Wars movie, I'm still thankful for it, because without A New Hope, there wouldn't be Attack of the Clones, which is my favorite. So, he said it's pretty much gonna have his take on it, have his point of view on what Narnia is, now, I'm going to put his video and stuff down in the description. I don't remember everything. It's a new start. In the Don Treader, we meet the character of Eustace. He's kind of like the Edmund of that story. There he is right there. And I forget the actor who plays him, but I think he's going to be... Rich Dog. I think he's going to be recast because the actor is too old, and he was asked if any of the other actors would return, and I believe none of the children, like Edmund, Susan, Lucy, and Peter, are in the Silver Chair. I don't remember. I think it's just kind of a new story, except for Eustace being in there. I knew Skandar Keynes, who played Edmund, I knew he probably wouldn't return to an Narnia film. He's 25 in real life, soon to be 26 in September, and he just kind of dropped out of acting. As much as I don't care how old he is, as much as I would love to see Edmund back, I don't care if he's 50, I would love to see him back, but I respect actors and their choices on to move on, because even though you're an actor, you don't have to stay. But, you know, I mean, obviously he's going to be known for the rest of his life as Edmund, you know? And same with the other actors. I don't know what... I know Peter Mosley... William Mosley, who played Peter, just was, like, in another... was in a Little Mermaid movie, not Disney, but about the fairy tale. And so he's still acting. I don't know about the other two. I think all of them except Skandar Keynes are still acting. And so I really, you know, and what's funny is each of the movies had a different feel, you know. In the first one, we were introduced to Narnia when it was during the White Witch's curse, the winter, and that's how we were introduced. In the second movie, when we first see Narnia, they are on a beach, and, you know, there's no more snow, the White Witch is dead. And her curse is obviously over. And then in the third movie, we are introduced to Narnia in the ocean. So each of the versions of Narnia have a different feel to them. So I can't really say I want the Silver Chair to have the same feel as the other ones, because they all have a different feel to it. So Silver Chair is definitely going to have a different feel to that movie, as do the other versions, you know. And, you know, it's not like Lord of the Rings, where they were in Middle Earth the whole time, where, you know, things were kind of had the same feel. Same with Star Wars, you know. Star Wars was about space and, you know, and stuff like that. So we were introduced to Narnia in different versions. Like I said, first movie snow, second movie beach, third movie the middle of the ocean. So I don't know how Silver Chair is introduced, because I never read the book, but it's gonna obviously be introduced in a different way. I know the villain isn't the White Witch, because she's dead, and I don't think the White Witch will appear. The White Witch is, the villain in Silver Chair is called the Emerald Witch, and I think the same actress who played the White Witch in BBC version also played the Emerald Witch in the BBC version, the Silver Chair 2. Let me see. I'm looking forward. I like female villains, I have to say. I really like female villains, mostly more than male villains. I think females are a little bit more entertaining. And that's just my opinion. Not that there's not entertaining male villains, but I think Furlough was entertaining and terrifying and stuff like that. And obviously Palpatine from Star Wars is like my favorite villain of all time. But I'm looking forward to see what they do with the Emerald Witch. It would be nice if they had cameos. Joe did say they would make references to other characters from the previous Narnia movie, so maybe Edmund will be mentioned. If a Eustace is going to be in it, obviously he spent time with Edmund and Lucy, so he's going to probably mention them. So I think this Narnia movie is going to be obviously from Joe's point of view, so it might not stick close to the book 100%, so don't, you know... you know, hate on him if it doesn't. And I think this movie's supposed to come out next year. That's what William Mosley said, Peter. But he could be wrong. But it's just starting to work on. But I'm really excited. I really hope it's not a letdown. The fact that Joe worked with Star Wars kind of has me set. Because Star Wars movies are amazing. So I'm looking forward to more Narnia movies. I do, again, hope it's not a letdown, because I also like the Pirates of the Caribbean movie, and there's a fifth movie coming out, and I like the first three ones, and then the fourth one came out, and half of the original cast, like Keira Knightley and Orlando Bloom, weren't there. And Elizabeth Swann was my favorite character, so it was kind of a letdown that she wasn't there. And I don't think she's back in this movie either, so it was kind of annoying. And there's sometimes with movie sagas and movie trilogies, there's just a certain point where you could have to stop. And I think Pirates of the Caribbean should have stopped at the third one. I wasn't a huge fan of the fourth one. With Narnia, if it's done right, and I know a lot of people probably thought it should have stopped at Don Treader, but with Narnia, if it's done right and entertaining, it can go on and make all the movies. With Lord of the Rings, I thought, even though Fellowship of the Ring isn't my favorite out of the three, and it drags on in my opinion as well, I thought it was a good ending with Return of the King, you know? They didn't have to end up like Two Towers or something. So I'm kind of looking forward to this. I'm sure, being a huge movie, that there will be toys out and stuff like that, and depends how Joe does this and what studio he goes with. I don't think Disney will have anything to do with this. Again, I'm gonna put his channel and video down in the description box below, and just you can listen to it. It's a good video. Kind of give you answers. Stuff like that. He said he's gonna try to stick to the book as much as possible. Again, it's hard to stick with the other movies because they are all different. And I just love them as much as I'll miss Tilda Swinton and Skandar Keynes. I will probably see this. It's kind of like with Force Awakens. Palpatine wasn't there, obviously. Padme wasn't there. It was kind of a new character. Leia was there. That was the exciting part to me, but I think I'm just gonna go into this, and I'll probably see it in the movie theaters. I'm probably just gonna go into this with an open mind, not gonna try not to think about the other movies as much, and just then have my opinion afterwards, because that's what I did with Beauty and the Beast and Rogue One and even Force Awakens. I just went in. Try not expect too much when you go into movies, especially, I'm lagging, so sorry if it's lagging. I don't know if it's lagging for you guys, but I'm not stopping the video, it's too much into the video. So, when movies come out in theaters that are part of a saga or sequels to try, or remake, try not to go into expecting I knew Beauty and the Beast was going to be a little different from the animated movie. There were some things I expected, like Belle, to be a certain way, but I do have faith in Joe Johnston to do the right thing with this movie. Hopefully he casts the right people, fits them, because personally, again, the cast of the characters in the other movies were perfect in my opinion. And I think they will be. So that's going to do it for this video. I'm going to stop rambling on. Let me know what you think. Go and watch the video down below. And let me know what you think after. Are you a Narnia fan? Are you looking forward to another Narnia film? Have you read the Narnia books? Let me know all that down below. So all my information, as always, is down below. Let me know what you think about this, guys. This is kind of huge because, again, the last Narnia movie was 2010, and it's kind of been on the down, Narnia has kind of, I am hoping when more information about Silver Chair and stuff comes, that it will kind of make Narnia a little bit more popular again, and make people go back and read the books or watch other movies, and, I would love to have Narnia fans to talk about. Edmund, or the story in general, or the White Witch. So let me know if you're a Narnia fan and what you think of the story, and who's your favorite Narnia character or characters. I have two, so if you didn't know, that would be the White Witch and Edmund. So let me know what you think in the comments below, and until the next video, I will see you guys later.
Okay, you guys made it to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Remember, you guys can follow me on the social media links I have in my channel and down below. And I also do have a fan mail address. If you would like to send fan mail, feel free to do so. And I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye.